Hello there, welcome to this lecture. Congratulations on installing Anaconda and Jupyter Notebook. In this lecture, you will go through Python programming. You will go through basics of Python programming and you will learn enough to go through this course. Python is high-level object-oriented programming language. It is easier than the programming languages like C, C++. And based on the kind of job functions you will be performing in a project, you can decide how much depth you need to have on Python programming. You might not be required to become a complete 100% Python programming expert. You will get a very good idea based on what you go through in this lecture. If you already know Python program, then you can skip this lecture and go to the next lecture. Let's begin. Okay. Once you have your Anaconda open, the Jupyter notebook. So this is the Jupyter notebook. I already opened it. Now I'm going to open a new Python 3 notebook. Awesome. So like any other programming language, first we have to give a title to the file. So I'm going to call it my first Python program. Okay. And like in any other programming language, when we learn a new programming language, the first thing we do is print hello world. How do you do that in Python? It's very easy. Just say print and say hello world. And here you go. It prints. So nothing can be easier than this, right? It's so easy. Very good. Now, next thing I'm going to talk about is how to give the comments. You can always give comment like here. This is comment. And it will not be considered in the program. Let's start the programming. First thing I want you to know is the indentation. The white space indentation in Python programming is very important. What do I mean by that? So let's say if I say for I in range 9, and see how it took me over here, indented. That's how it knows whatever I'm going to write now, it is for this loop. So I say print I. And let's see, here it prints all 0 to 9 numbers, right? It's for part of the for loop. If I say print done here, for example, it's going to print done so many times because that is part of the loop. And it knows that this print is part of the loop because I followed the same indentation, right? What if I just do this? Then it will not be part of the loop. That print done will print only at the end of the loop. So that's how important the indentation is, right? Okay, the next I'm going to talk about the data types and the variables. In Python programming, you don't have to declare the type of your variables. You can directly assign the numbers or string and Python will know what kind of variable it is. So let's say if I say j equal 10 and name equals Sanrusha. So now Python knows that j is an integer variable and name is a string variable. I need not declare that. So if I print here, print j and print name, here I go, and I can always reassign the values. So I can say reassign the value here 11 and name Sandoksa 2, and here you go. So that's how these variables play a role in Python programming. Next, let's talk about different data structures. So let's say data structures. So associated arrays are called dictionaries in Python. So let's say if I am creating my first dictionary, if I do it like this, just say name Sandoksa, then age, then location, multinational. Okay, so that's the dictionary. Now if I want to print a specific value, I have to say dict1 and then I have to put the name of the associated index. So in this case it will be Sandoksa, right? And if I want to get the age, then it will be dict1 and age. Here you go. So easy. So that is the data structure for dictionaries. Next type of data is called list. So list is basically ordered array. What do I mean by this? Like if I say list1 here, I can just create list of values, and it need not be just one type of value. It can be a string, it can be integer, and it can be combinations of string and integer, and it can be array within array. So let's say 10, 50, Sandoksa, India, and 65. Print list1. Here you go. What if I want the first value? So that would be list1 and 0. The list values, the index of the list values starts with 0. So this is 0 index 1, 2, 3, 4. So if I want to get this value India, then I have to put the index here 0, 1, 2, and 3, right? Let's say 3. Here you go, I get India. And as I said before, we can have array, that means list within the list. So I can say list 2 equals, maybe put the same values, and then within this I can have another list, like I can say 45 35 24. And now if I print, so let's comment this, I don't want to print this again, so comment that, and now let's print list 2. See, what if I want this 45? How will that go? Any guess? So this is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, and this array itself is index 5, and within index 5, this is 0. So if I want to get this 45, I have to print it like this. Print list 2, and then 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, okay, 5, and then this is 0 index on the 5th value, 0, here 45, if I want to get 35, then 1. So that's how the list within list works. Okay, so this one was about list, right? There's another data structure and that's very popular and that's called tuples. The difference between tuples and the list is tuples you cannot modify. Once you assign a value in the tuples, you cannot modify that value. In programming language, it is called immutable. You cannot change the value, so tuples are immutable. Okay, let's say my first tuple, tuple 1 is, you put like this, 10, 50, 12, 5, and Sanjay. Okay, that's my first tuple. And likewise, like in list, if you want to print a specific value in tuple, then it's the same thing, tuple 1 and then the value. Let's say one here, 50. And here's the fun part, like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So I can have 5 variables, where 1, where 2, where 3, where 4, and where 5. And I can directly assign my tuple to these values. What do you think? What will happen if I print the second variable now? What would be the value? 50. What is the first one? 10. What's the fifth one? Sanjay. So the point is, all these tuple values got assigned to these variables just with this assignment. Isn't that good? It's easy, right? Next, let's talk about flow control. So flow control, like any other programming language, you can have flow control like if, then, else, all those things in Python too. So for example, if I say, let's say a is equals 0 as a variable, and if you say if age is less than 18, print teen. Else print adult, and let's say age is 12. And here you go. So that's if then else, like any other programming language, right? That is easy part. Next, we're going to talk about function definition. It's very easy to create a function in Python language. You just say function and name my first func, name of the function, and then the attributes, the parameters you want to pass to function. Let's say p1 num and p2 num, and then create here and put the details of your function inside this. Let's say I'm just going to say p1 num plus p2 num. Just say this function is going to return p1 num and p2 num, right? So return p1 num and p2 num. So very small function. Okay, my function is ready. And now I am going to call this function. Let's say print my first func, and I'm saying 10 and 20. Here you go. I get the 30, the return. So that's so easy to create a function in Python program. Before I move on from function, let me tell you one very interesting feature. Like if I want to put some comment here in my function, right? I say function documentation. This is my first Python function. Okay. And if you just run this command, my first funcs dot underscore doc two underscores, you will get the comment here, my first function, Python function, right? So make sure, or maybe this is a good practice, that when you write a function, please put this function documentation, so that anyone who wants to know the detail behind that function, they can just run this command and all those documentation will be shown there. So even without opening your function, your code, they can know what is it about. So that's a good practice, standard practice you should follow. I think we covered pretty much everything you need to know. One very important feature of Python programming left is, as I said, Python programming is object oriented programming. It's also open source language. So a lot of people have already written a lot of libraries, and that is going to save a lot of time for you. You do not have to write every function, every procedure from scratch. Whatever you want to do, maybe somebody has already wrote a library for that, and you just need to import that module, that library, in your Python program. For example, there is a very popular library called NumPy. So I just say import NumPy as np, and I can perform a lot of mathematical operations using NumPy. Let's create a simple list. So I'm going to create a simple list, list 3, of numbers 10, 3, 5, 15, and 45, 65, 2, 55. So it's a list, but it's not ordered. What if I want this list to be ordered? Using NumPy, you can do that. So NumPy dot sort and then list 3. Over here, you got it sorted, right? So you do not have to write a complete new module or new function to sort your list. It's already there. You just need to import NumPy, and then using that module, you can do these kind of functions. There are several other functions you can do using NumPy. Most of mathematical operations can be performed using this module. And this is just one module. So there are several other modules already available. It was a big lecture. And if you are new to Python, you might have to come back to this again. But I think that's pretty much what you need to know for now. I will see you in next lecture.